Hello friends, in this video we are going to see a modification to nodal analysis technique, and that is called as supernode analysis. So I will consider a circuit having resistances connected in parallel and voltage source connected between two nodes, and then I am considering a current source with a resistance parallel to it. I will give the values R1, R2, R3. Let's take this as voltage source of V and current source of I ampere. Now we have to analyze this circuit using nodal analysis. Let's define how many nodes are there in this circuit. Node number 1. So I'll write Vx as a potential of node X, Vy a potential of node Y, and obviously I'll consider this node where four branches are connected as a reference. Now here problem is, I'm not having any resistance connected in this branch. So if I write an equation, I may get an infinite. To avoid this, instead of writing an equation for this branch current, I will simply consider this as IV. Current flowing through this branch, I mentioned as IV, is nothing but current flowing through this voltage source. Let's apply KCL at node X. So I am considering random current directions only except for the current source, which I will give current direction same as whatever current value and its direction it is having. Applying KCL at node X gives me 0 minus Vx divided by R1 equal to Vx minus 0 divided by R2 plus IV. See here, I'm not going to apply any equation like Vx minus Vy minus V divided by R, because R is not known or it's not given. So if I write that equation, it will give you infinite value. So there is a problem. So instead of writing an equation for this branch current, I'll simply mention IV, and I will consider this as equation number 1. Similarly, I can apply KCL at node Y. So at node Y, this current is incoming along with this I, and only outgoing current is current flowing through R3. So I will write the equation IV plus I equal to Vy minus 0 divided by R3. This is equation number 2. Remember, we have solved numericals where I'm getting the equations in terms of node voltages only. So here, along with the node voltages, I'm having this IV term extra. I is a constant, so that is not a problem. So I need to eliminate this IV. So see how I'm going to eliminate IV. So from equation 1, I can say IV equal to minus Vx by R1 minus Vx by R2. So I will just rearrange the terms so that IV will be on one side of equation and remaining terms will be on another side of equation. Similarly, from equation 2, I can get IV as Vy divided by R3 minus I. Another equation I'll get equation number 4. I can equate these two equations. And I can say minus Vx by R1 minus Vx by R2 equal to Vy by R3 minus I. Let's rearrange the terms. So after rearranging the terms, I am getting Vx in a bracket 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus Vy 1 by R3. I'll take this minus I on this side. I, equation number 5. So now what I have done, I have written two equations in terms of IV as a third variable. Since I'm having two nodes, so I should only have two equations and two variables. But this particular circuit having voltage source between two nodes given, because of that I'm getting third variable IV also. So I eliminated the third variable IV like this. So ultimately this equation I will get. Second equation I need to form. So let's go back to the circuit once again. So if you see circuit closely, I'll come to know V is a voltage source given between two points X and Y. So obviously it is a potential difference between these two nodes. So I can write Vx minus Vy equal to V. Remember, voltage source V and current source I are the constants. So I'll get equation number 6. So equation 5 and equation 6 are in terms of node voltages, and solving them I will get node voltages Vx and Vy. So our work is done, but we need to apply such a long process. In order to avoid that, let's generalize the thing. Now let's go back to the equation 5 once again. It is Vx bracket 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus Vy 1 by R3 equal to I. So let's generate this equation directly. Okay, so I will consider a circuit once again. So better I will draw the circuit removing V voltage source. So the circuit will be like this. So I remove the voltage source, means I have considered that as a short circuit. Now these are R1, R2, R3, current source having a value I, this potential is Vx, this potential is Vy, and current directions I will keep same as the original circuit. And now I will apply KCL to this node which we consider as arbitrarily same. I'll name it as Supernode. It's a combination of two nodes. So let's apply KCL at Supernode. So for Supernode, I'm having these two incoming currents. So I'll write equations. So for this current, it is starting from this reference and ending on Vx divided by R1. This current is I because it's a current source, equal to outgoing currents. Two outgoing currents. One is at this node, Vx minus 0 divided by R2. And for this node, it is Vy minus 0 divided by R3. After rearranging the terms, I will get Vx in a bracket 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 Vy 1 upon R3 equal to I. I'll consider this as the equation number 7. And if I look at equation number 5 and equation number 7, equation number 5 is like this: Vx 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus Vy 1 by R3 equal to I, and equation 7 is also same. So instead of considering two equations and then eliminating third variable, getting one more equation, better we can apply this concept which we call as a supernode. So you have to apply KCL as if considering this is a one node but having two potentials, and write the terms, get only one equation, and other equation you will get from this voltage source. So here voltage source is connected between two nodes. Vx minus Vy will be the V. So I will consider this as equation of voltage source. So here we have seen a concept of supernode. In subsequent videos, we will solve numericals based on this. Thank you.